Hello, it's me. I probably should have figured out a place to put the camera before I started filming, but I didn't. So, okay, how's this? I don't have many options. Let's move forward. I came up with this video idea a little while ago, and I'm sure as you can tell by the title, this is gonna be a video about outfits that I think are super cute, but I'm just not confident enough to wear them outside of the house or wear them at all. I don't wear them inside of my house either. I don't wear them at all. But I have a ton of clothes and I haven't actually thought of the outfits yet. Baby, can you get down? She's on my clothes all the time. I haven't actually thought of the outfits yet. I'm just kinda gonna wing it as I go along. I have like a bunch of clothes out here, and I brought my sock drawer out here also, cause socks are a thing that I feel like I have a lot of really cute socks that I don't wear. Oh, and also shoes. I have shoes over there. So yeah, I'm just gonna come up with stuff. I'm gonna try and do 10. I think 10 is a good amount. Maybe 5 if I'm like not feeling it. Get off, get down, please, thank you. Yeah, I'm gonna try and see what I can come up with and cry and, oh my gosh, I'm totally gonna make, I thought I was gonna make the title something else, but now I know what I'm gonna make the title. Outfits I would never wear out in public. Change my mind. Because of that meme, that change my mind meme, maybe that's trendy. Maybe it'll make people want to click on my video. I don't know. Is that dumb? Okay, anyways, we're gonna get to business. I have to figure out where to put the camera so you can see me, but I have beautiful natural lighting that is kind of shifty and not the best, but I'm gonna work with it. So, stay tuned, get ready for the fashion show. Okay, so we're starting out pretty tame. I even feel uncomfortable like filming in this. Okay, I hope you can hear me okay. This is a pair of overalls that I got from Goodwill. They have fish embroidery. I don't know how well you can see it. It's lighting. But they have they have cute little fish on them. And I don't know what to say. I really love these overalls a lot with my entire heart. I think they're cute as all hell. Maybe I could like roll them up. Is that a thing that people do? Roll them up. Right? Roll them up. I could do like one side exposed, I guess. I don't know. I feel so uncomfortable. Okay. I have this weird thing where I feel like when I dress like this, I look like I'm 5 years old and people are gonna make fun of me and think that I look stupid. And it makes me sad because I really like clothes like this and it makes me feel really good about myself. And I think that it's really cute and I love this shirt, even though it's kind of annoying because I have to like adjust it a bunch so that it doesn't like floof out. But like, I think it's cute, but like, I would never wear this. I would never leave the house in this. I would be uncomfortable all day long. I would be worried about my crotch right up and how my butt looked and like, if the shirt was riding up in the back. And also, like, I don't know what shoes I would wear with this. I have these gold flats and they kind of match like the yellow golden fish in the middle, but like I feel like flats make my feet look big. And also, I have on these really cute socks. They're like stripy socks that I like that have like the pink and stuff from this fish and the green and stuff. But then I'm like, well, I wouldn't wear these flats with these socks. But I don't like necessarily just wearing flats with shorts because I don't like how big my feet are. And I feel like socks help make them look less big. But tell me what you think. I've been talking for a very long time. This is gonna be a long video, I can already tell. But tell me what you think. I feel so dumb. Okay, outfit number one, fish. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, I've decided that we're gonna do this in themes. So I'm gonna do overalls and like jeans and dresses like together. So this is the overalls category. If you've been following me on Instagram for a long time, you've probably seen these many times. These are my favorite overalls in the entire universe. They have Winnie the Pooh on them. I love Winnie the Pooh with my whole entire heart. They have a little embroidered honey pot with some bees on the butt. And then I think it says 100 acre woods on here. And they have all these like details. I'm out of breath. Oh my gosh. Oh, okay. So the shorts are kind of like on the longer side. So I would definitely have to roll them up, I think, for them to look a little less silly. Like, maybe like that. I don't know. I got these on Depop. I fell in love with them the second that I saw them. I think I paid a lot for them, actually. They weren't cheap. And I actually did wear these in public one time. I wore them to school, and I posted pictures on Instagram, and you all thought that I looked really cute, and I was feeling it. And then I got to school, and I wanted to die all day long because everybody was staring at me and asking me why I was wearing a costume. And it was awful. It was one of the worst school days that I've ever had. And I was really sad because when I was like getting ready in the morning, I felt really cute. But again, I feel like I look 5 years old and I'm 19, and people don't take very well to someone that looks like they're an adult wearing clothes that belong to a baby. But again, I think it's cute, but I would never dare to wear these outside because of the horrors that ensued when I did. And also, the reason that I'm wearing this top again is because I don't have any other like white tops that would go under overalls, which is also a problem that I have. I feel like I have a hard time like mixing stuff and like finding like a shirt to wear under something or like wear under a jacket. And that's an issue that I have. Also, another issue that I have is that I don't know what shoes to wear with this either. I can't even remember what shoes I wore. I think I wore these. I think I wore these boots. They have like flowers on them and they match kind of. I think they're cute. I think I wore these, but I can't remember. And then like I would wear, I didn't bother to put the socks on because I'm lazy, but I would wear these socks with the little ruffles because like it matches and it's pink. And I think that would look super cute. But hell no. Hell to the no. I would never leave the house looking like this. Never, 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 never. I would die. So I can just enjoy it in my home and feel cute in my home. Tell me what you think. Do you even like me in overalls? Do you think I look stupid in overalls? I feel like I kind of look dumb in overalls sometimes. Like maybe, I don't know. I'm not gonna say anything anymore. You tell me what you think about the poo. The Winnie the poo poo poo. Poo 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 poo. Be right back. Okay. These are some overalls that my mom got me at Goodwill. She loves them. My mom loves these overalls so much. And I think they're cute too. I left them kind of like unraveled so that I could show you how you can like change them up. I don't know if you can see them very good. Yeah, you can see them. Okay. Okay, so they have, well, they had buttons right here and like the straps hooked onto the buttons, but the straps are like way too long. So I took the buttons off and tied it in a knot because otherwise it'd like hang like way down. So I like tied it and the knot's really ugly and I don't know how to make a knot cute. But okay, so this strap, okay. You put it through the loop and then I think, oh yeah, got it. I think it's too short, that's okay. Anyways, so you can tie it up like this. It has a pocket in the front and it kind of hangs down and it has these buttons on the side that are really cute. And then in the back here, it has this drawstring that you can pull and you can like cinch it at the waist to make it tighter. And then you can just tie it up and make it tighter however you want. And like that makes your butt look really good, I think. When you tighten it, tighten it up, hoists it up on your butt, makes your butt look good. And they're kind of like a capri kind of length. I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see it. They're kind of like capris. And when my mom bought them, they were like rolled up a bunch like that. And I don't really know how that looks, but they were rolled up like that. And they have this really cool fabric. I don't know how well you can tell. I can't really see too good. But they have this really cool like fabric. It has like this weird pattern on it. It almost kind of looks like leaves and like cross hatching. And it's like different on different panels. And I think these are so cute. And they're so soft and comfortable. And they have pockets. And I just feel super relaxed and chill. But again, they're overalls and I feel like I look stupid in overalls. And again, I don't know what shoes I would wear with these. My shoes, I have tons of shoes and nothing to wear any of the shoes with. Maybe I'd wear them. I guess I could wear it with these. These shoes I wear like every single day. I got them for $5 at Walmart. And they're just like my shoes that I guess it kind of works with the black tank top. Also, I had no clue what tank top to wear under this. I have the one that I just had on, the off the shoulder thing. I have this black like ribbed one, but like it where the straps meet the shirt itself, and then like on the seams on the side, it's like scratchy, it like itches. And so I don't like wearing this anyways. And I don't have any other shirts that I could wear with these. And I just don't know. Okay, I feel like I kind of look like a hobo. I feel like I look lazy and like disheveled. But it's kind of like a look, you know what I mean? But again, if I'm not like, if I wore these, I would stand out in a crowd. You know what I mean? Like this is like wearing something like this is like something that people are gonna notice me in. So, what do you think? Overalls number 3. These are the last overalls that I have. I used to have a pair of denim ones, but I got rid of them because, again, I felt like I looked stupid and they made my butt look really small. So I got rid of them, but tell me what you think. Help my sister out. I would really appreciate it. See you in my next outfit. Okay. We're back. This outfit is an outfit that I almost wore like a few days ago, a week ago, something. I have no clue. This outfit's basically about the top, less than it is about the jeans, because I've worn these jeans, and I think these jeans look good on me, and I feel cute, even though they kind of emphasize my fupa a little bit, but it's okay. I'm fine with the foop. What I'm not fine with is this top. That's bullshit. I'm fine with this top. I love this top. I think this top looks great on me. I think that it just really does wonders for my body. I think it looks cute. But I don't like wearing bras. I never wear bras, never will wear bras, hate bras, think they're awful. This top makes my boobs look very sad. Saggy and floop, floop, floop. And the fabric is really thin, and my nipples kind of poke out a little bit. And also, I don't know if you noticed, but the pants kind of make my stomach. But if you look at me from far away and don't think about it, this top is cute as hell, right? And it's so soft, and I feel like this outfit makes my legs look so long because I have such short legs. And I really like how it's like short sleeved and then it comes up, but I'm insecure about my arms because my arms are kind of fat and I don't like showing my arms, but I don't have like a leather jacket or anything to wear with this because the only leather jacket I have is way too small. So I would never wear this out in public by itself because boobs and arms. Okay. I know, the shirt's too small, it's gaping in the front, and it's also see-through so you can see my nipples. But come on, isn't it cute as hell? I wore this shirt in high school one time, and let me tell you, that was a beautiful day. I had to wear a very small and tight sports bra to squish my tits down enough for this to actually fit me right. You probably have to wear a binder with this, to be honest, because it's a size small, and I am definitely not a size small. But, anyways, I wore this in high school, and I wore it with a little black skirt, and I think I wore it with some heels and like, maybe some like thigh-high socks or something like that. I don't know. It was not an appropriate outfit for high school at all. But I looked hot as hell. I felt hot as hell. This is when I had short hair. And I was trying to embrace my look. Well, that day, a male teacher, I think he was gay. I think. Let me preface. I think he was gay. But he told me that my outfit was really cute. And man, oh man, did that feel good. He didn't have to tell me that I looked cute, but he said, that's a really cute outfit. And I was like, I can never get rid of the shirt now because I was gonna sell the shirt. I got it on Depop. I'm an itch. I got it on Depop and I was just gonna like resell it on Depop. It has a sailor thing in the back also. I was just gonna resell it on Depop, but after that, it has a memory attached to it of a really good day. I just can't get rid of it. So, I will forever have this really cute top, and it has really cute buttons down the front. I don't know if you can see, but it has really cute buttons, and it ties, and okay, this is another one of these boob shirts that make my boobs kind of look floppy, and it kind of sits at a weird place, but it's so like cool. It's like color blocked, so it has this black section and this heather gray section, and it's a cashmere sweater, and it like, I don't know. It looks kind of cool. I think it's cute, but I just feel like I maybe look kind of strange in it. I'm not sure if it's because of the fact that, like, this black and then this black just kind of makes things look weird. Am I too much? Like, it blends too much? I kind of like it. I think it's kind of cute on the right day with the right outfit and maybe like the right accessories. I think that it's really kind of like edgy and modern. And like, I'm pretty sure, oh God, who's that girl? On Instagram, that was like a Viner that does YouTube, and like everybody loves her. She literally has like most perfect face I've ever seen, and I'm so jealous. But that's beyond the point. What's her name? Anya, I think it is. Anya, I don't know. But I feel like she would look cute in this shirt. So why can't I look cute in this shirt? You know? What do you think? Tell me. I wouldn't wear it outside because I'm not confident in it, but I think that it's kind of a look. Right? Yes? No? So? Help me, please. Hello. I'm going to add this in really quick. I just had to delete like two things that I was wearing because one of them, you could see my boobs very, very, very clearly through the shirt, like really awfully, and I didn't notice. And then also, a pair of pants looked really bad on me, and I just didn't want to show them. But this one that I'm going to be talking about right now, with the green pants and the red coat, I'm going to show the part with the coat because I really want you guys to see the coat. And I think the coat's really cute, but I'm going to cut out all the parts where you can see my nipples through the black shirt because it's awful, and you don't want to see that. So you're welcome. And please, please look. Look at this. How cute. How cute is this, right? Like, honestly, it's so freaking cute. It's this little red jacket. Please, okay? Please tell me this jacket is not cute. But my problem is, I don't have anything to wear it with. And I literally love it so much. And I want to wear it all the time, and I look at it all the time. But I just don't know what to wear. This is a dress that I've had for about 3 summers now, and have yet to wear outside. Why? I don't know. Because it's a really beautiful dress. It's so flowy and so magical. It's a little bit long on me, but that's not a big deal. The bust is this like beautiful embroidered black like X's and like stripes, and it fits me like a glove. And it's so soft and so comfortable, and it's the perfect little run on the beach, dance in a music video, spin in the wind, enjoy a summer breeze kind of dress. But I feel like I look kind of funny in it. I feel like I look like a mom. One. Two, I feel like it makes my shoulders look really broad. And three, it probably wouldn't fall down. It's pretty secure. But I can't commit. I can't do it. I don't know why. I really love this dress so much. It's one of my favorite dresses that I own. And I just can't work up enough courage to wear it. There's not much else to say about it. It's beautiful. I'm shitty. That's basically how most of this is. It's beautiful and I just suck. But we're gonna work on that, I promise. I'm gonna show you the next dress. This is a dress that I got at Goodwill a while ago. And I fell in love with it the moment that I saw it. It was brand new, still had the tags, is so perfectly like tailored and just like well made. It has little soft little shoulder pads, and it has these adorable little ducks on the front, and then this little bow and this little like ribboning embroidery, and then this embroidery on the neckline with the button and this cute little pocket. And I love everything about this dress. I love the fit. I love the color. I just love the way that it looks. I think it's so cute. But I feel like I look like a waitress or like a servant or a maid or something. And I don't know when I would wear this. I don't know where I would wear this. I don't know. I just have no clue. I don't know what shoes I would wear with it. I thought maybe I'll wear it for Thanksgiving because it kind of looks like a Thanksgiving dress, right? But Thanksgiving had come and gone, and I had another dress that I wanted to wear. But it's definitely not a summer dress. It's maybe an Easter dress, possibly. I could wear it for Easter, but I don't think my family's doing anything for Easter, and Nick and I are definitely not doing anything because we have no money. So this is just going to sit in my closet until Thanksgiving rolls around again, and then I'm going to say, well, I should wear it for Thanksgiving, and then I won't because I'll want to wear something else because I'm too insecure to wear this outside because I feel like I stand out and nobody wears clothes like this where I live, and it's the same story. But I can appreciate it, and I can be happy that I own it and think that it's cute and that it makes me happy. I'll put it on every once in a while and just look at it in the mirror and smile, and I guess that's all I really need. Tell me what you think. It's also a very, very nice length, isn't it? It's just so cute.
Nick called me while he's at work and interrupted me, so that last video got cut off, but I'm pretty sure I said everything I wanted to say. Anyways, so it's okay. We'll just move on to the next one. This is a dress that you guys have seen on Instagram probably, but you haven't seen it in all of its glory, okay? This is the most beautiful dress that I own. This is a royal purple velvet princess dress. Okay, I don't even want to call it a dress. It's so much more than a dress, okay? It's a mood, it's a feeling, it's an emotion, it's a day. It is just everything. Look at this beauty, look at this beautiful purple velvet. Honey, let me tell you something, okay? I have been so into velvet lately. I've bought like 3 velvet dresses in the past like month. I have velvet shoes. I want everything velvet in my life. It is so soft, so beautiful. I feel like it just represents me and my aesthetic so well because it's just like shiny and soft and elegant and beautiful. And I'm none of those things, but I wanna be, goddammit. And I love this dress. Look at this. Okay, honestly, hang on. Give me a second, okay? Look at this. I always have issues with length. Like the length of the dress, always have issues. This dress, perfectly perfect. I don't even have to say anything. It's perfect. And the way that it just does me so good. It does me so good. But it's a purple velvet dress. And I don't know where the hell I would wear this. I don't know when I would wear it. I have no clue. And so therefore, it will sit in my closet. And I will be sad. And I will think about it every day. And I mean, it's like a winter dress, to be honest. And winter has passed many months ago. winter just passed, actually. But, like, you know, the heat of winter when it's Christmas time and, like, everyone's in that mood. That mood is past many months ago. So, I'll be sad. But I can still be happy because it's beautiful. Did I say I got this at Goodwill? I got this at Goodwill for like $8. So don't sleep on Goodwill now, okay? I know that they're ethically not probably the best company ever, but they sell some gems, okay? They sell some gems and you're missing out. I could have missed out on this, but I didn't. I didn't, and I'm so grateful. I am so grateful. I love it. It's so pretty. And then, okay, also in the same vein with this, I'm just gonna like throw this on over top of this dress because I don't know how else to show it to you guys. But I have this coat, okay? Oh God, you guys are probably gonna roast me. This coat is falling apart, okay? It's falling apart. It has moths, like moths have eaten the fabric in some places, like down here, which I didn't know and I was really pissed about when I got it. It has this fur collar and it has these fur cuffs that I put on wrong, I think. I don't know, maybe they go like this. I think that's how they go. These fur cuffs. I'm just gonna show you guys this really quick because this is something that I've had for years, and I have yet to wear it. And I'll just throw it on over this dress, because it's a long coat, and long coat, and long dress. You know, it's cute. But the story about this dress, I saw this on, I think it was Poshmark, maybe? A few years ago, this girl was selling this on Poshmark, and I fell in love instantaneously. I thought it was the most beautiful coat I had ever seen in my entire life, and I needed it, okay? I needed this coat with every ounce of my being. I needed this coat, okay? And, you know, I didn't have the money for it, because it's not like it was a cheap coat. She was probably selling it for like $100 or something like that. And I'll be right back. I have to blow my nose. I'm back, okay. I'm sorry. My nose is always running. But anyway, I just burped. I'm sorry. Anyways, expensive coat, couldn't afford it, beautiful, fell in love instantaneously, blah, blah, blah. Forgot about it, moved on. Then I joined Depop, and I found this dress again on Depop. A different girl was selling it. I'm pretty sure it's the same dress, but a different girl was selling it on Depop for a little bit cheaper. And I had a little bit of money because I had a job at the time, and I was like, I really need this. Like, I just need it. I don't know. I couldn't get it off my mind. And it was making me, like, depressed thinking about it because I wanted it so bad. And it just felt so meant to be. It felt so meant to be. And so I messaged the girl and I asked her if we could maybe arrange some sort of, like, partial trade, where I would give her some of the items on my Depop shop and then pay a portion of the price of the dress, and she would give me the dress. And lo and behold, she agreed. And I mean, I still paid $60 for this dress, but anyways, she agreed and we did the trade and I got the dress. And I mean, I loved it right away. It's too small. It's too tight in the waist. The measurements, I'm a little bit too fat for it. But I thought I could lose some weight. But anyways, I got the dress, or the, not the dress, the coat. And the buttons, some of the buttons are like falling off. They're really loose. And it has some spots where like moths have eaten the fabric. And that's like something that you can't really fix. I mean, you might be able to fix it with darning, but I don't know how exactly that would look. And it's really heavy. Like, insanely heavy. Like, you pick it up and it's, like, heavy. It's probably at least like 10 pounds. I'm gonna say. That's how heavy it is. It's a heavy dress. The material is very thick. It's very warm. This is a very tailored dress. This was an expensive dress. Whoever, like, originally purchased this dress paid a... I'm calling it a dress. It's not a dress. It's a coat. Whoever purchased this coat spent a lot of money on it. And it has this cape also. This little cape with a collar. That you tie like this. Okay. Listen. If any of you have ever been interested in, like, what is it? I don't even know what it's called. Like, kawaii clothing. Like, Japanese stuff. I don't know. I don't know how to describe it. I was going through this phase where I really just really loved everything that was, like, kawaii and, like, Japanese and this, like, cute style where, like, you know what I'm talking about. I ain't gotta explain it, okay? But I was in that phase and I felt like it was me and like what I needed, and I bought all these dresses. You've probably seen a few of the dresses that I have. I've sold them since. That it's just this cutesy style. And when I saw this dress, I just thought that it was gonna be the perfect affirmation because it's wearable. It's not like totally out there. You know what I mean? It's kind of out there. It's out there enough that I haven't worn it yet, okay? And that I haven't fixed the buttons or tried to darn the wool or anything. But, where am I getting with this? Okay, I love this dress, or this coat. I love this coat so much. I love it so much with my entire heart and soul. It is the most beautiful coat I've ever seen in my life. I will never get rid of this coat. I feel so beautiful in this coat. I really do want to get this coat fixed, but I'm just not confident enough to wear it out. It's a winter coat. I don't know where the hell I would wear it. I don't go to any events. I don't go to any parties or anything where this would be appropriate. You know, just going to Walmart, going to the mall. This is excessive. You know what I mean? And I just am not... I feel like I'm just not cut out for doing things that are bold, you know? This is a bold statement. This is a statement piece, okay? And the hems, like, come undone over here. But it is very beautiful. I'm just sad, okay? I'm sad because I do love these things, and these things make me happy. And I'm just not willing to take the steps to make it me. You know? And that's sad. That's just really sad. Because I want it to be me. You know? I really do. I've had this dress for like 3 years. Probably not 3 years. Probably like 2 years. Maybe it is 3 years. It's been a long time. I'll tell you that. It's been a very, very long time that I've had this dress. And she is beautiful, and I'm sad that, one, that the girl didn't tell me that it was damaged, because I probably wouldn't have bought it if I knew that it was damaged, and two, I'm sad that I haven't, like, I don't know, I haven't tried to get it fixed or anything, because I probably could. It's probably not that big of a deal to fix some little moth holes, and I don't know. Is it even cute? Tell me what you think, okay? What if it's, you guys probably think it's ugly. Maybe. I don't know. Also, these are, like, removable. The fluff is, like, removable. It, like, buttons on in here. And you can take it off, so it has no fluff. And same with this collar. It's removable, so it has this, this collar under here. This is, like, the moth hole. There's another one, too, but I can't remember where it is. These are the buttons, yes. The cape. The collar. I think it's cute, but I'm just too damn insecure. I'm too insecure. Okay, this is the end of the video. I've talked so much. I have so much editing to do. I have a lot of work ahead of me, okay? I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that, I don't know, maybe I like inspired you or something. Maybe you liked some of my outfits and you were like, wow, that's cute, I wanna get something like that. And now you feel inspired. Or like, maybe you're like, damn, Danny, your taste is awful. I can't believe that you would ever even buy these things. No wonder you can't wear them outside of the house, because they're ugly. Maybe that's how you feel. I don't know. Tell me how you feel in the comments. Tell me how you feel on Instagram. Message me, roast me, whatever you want. Also, tell me what you think of my makeup, because I just started doing my makeup like this yesterday. So this is my second attempt. It's kind of messy. I didn't do that much of a good job, I don't think. I'm kind of questioning it. But people on Instagram seem to like it for the most part. So tell me what you think. Tell me what you think about my clothes, about my mess, messy house. Yes, I made a mess. I cleaned my house. I spent all day on my day off cleaning the entire house, and I just made it a mess again. Tell me what you think about my dog. My dog is a goblin right now. I shaved all her hair off, and now she's a shaved goblin, and I still love her. She's cute, and you should still love her too. I'm rambling. I don't know why. Thank you for watching my video. I really appreciate it. I hope you watched the whole thing. If you didn't, it doesn't really matter anyways, because I'm not making any money off of this. So I'm just here for your entertainment. I love you so much. I really appreciate you supporting me and loving me and watching my shit. It makes me feel good. It encourages me to keep doing this and do more stuff like this. I really want to make a lot more YouTube videos. I just have to take the initiative and do it. But I think that's it. I hate when the lighting like blows out like that. Okay, anyways, I'm gonna go. I've been talking for way too long. Thanks again for watching. I've probably said that 15 times, but thank you again for watching. I appreciate it. I love you. I've said this 15 times, but I can't stop talking. I'm gonna go now. Love you. Bye.